start. I'll keep watching and getting kids in.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so raise your hand if you've taken a ballet class before. Okay, so a few of you. That's good. Okay, so this is going to be really basic, just, you know, positions and just like basic bar technique. So if everyone has a place they can stand up to start. I'm going to adjust this so you can see me. Okay, so if everyone just wants to follow along for this, hang on, I have to let someone in. Who joined? Hi. Okay, so just follow along. We're just gonna do a little warm up. Okay, so arms up. Deep breath. Let it go. Touch your toes. Maybe swing side to side. Roll up. One more time. Arms up. Breathe in. Let it go. Down the floor. Touch your toes. Swing side to side. And roll up. Roll your shoulders back a couple times. Just get them long. And forward. Now arm swing. And forward. Now roll your head to the right. Keep rolling your head. And to the other way. Shake it up. Shake, 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 shake. Okay. So we're gonna learn the beginning positions that you use in ballet. So we're gonna learn the foot positions first. So hopefully you can see my feet if I'm like this. So obviously parallels when your feet are forward. First position is when you just rotate your feet out. So this is a very common ballet position for when you're first learning. And then second position is when you just tendu to the side. So first and second, which is what we'll be using. And your arms. So low fifth. Or en bas, and then first, you want to keep your elbows up. So they shouldn't droop, you should keep them up, and pretend you have a necklace on that you're trying to show off. So keep your chest open. And then second position. Perfect, you guys are doing so good already. Okay, so now we're gonna learn what a plié is. Okay. Does anyone know what a plié is? Can you show me? Good, Savannah. Good. You guys already know what it is. Perfect. Okay. For those of you who don't know, a plié is when you're in first position, the first position I showed you with your feet, and your arms are low, and you just bend your knees. That's a plié. But when you do a plié, you want to keep your posture. So what I mean by posture is holding your tummy, like squeezing your tummy. That's called holding in your core. And you want to roll your shoulders back so you can get as tall as possible. So you should, let me see my side. So This is tummy out, tummy in, and then shoulders back. So it should look like this. And you want to maintain that when you're doing everything in ballet. So you want to maintain that when you're doing pliés, which is really important. It's how you build your skills. So. Wait, hang on. We're going to do a simple plié combination. You're just going to follow along with me. Do you guys like Frozen? Yeah? You like Frozen? Should we play a Frozen song to do our pliés to? Yeah? You guys like Let It Go, right? Okay. I'm going to play it and you guys tell me if you can hear it. Can you hear it? Okay. So I'm going to play the song. Just follow along. Do as best as you can. What a grand plié is. A grand plié is the same as a plié, but you just take it to the floor. So, okay. So, what you just did was a plié when you bend your knees. I'll turn this side so you can see it. A plié. A grand plié is when you go, so you go down. You want to maintain your posture. You don't want to just like plop on your heels. You want to like engage. It's supposed to be controlled. And then you try to get your heels to touch the floor as soon as possible. Push yourself up. So, this side, you have your normal plié, and then you have your grand plié. You go down. Very good. And then you try to get your heels to touch the floor as soon as possible, and then you go up. Does everyone sort of get that? Yeah? So now we're going to add it to our plié combination. So just follow along.
Makes everything seem small, and the fears that once controlled me can't get to me at all. It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and break through. No light, no rope, no rules for me.
So you've learned first and second position with your arms and your feet, and you've learned a plié and a grand plié.
Does everyone know what a tendu is, or some people? No? Perfect. Oh, some people do. Okay. Well, I'm going to teach you it. So a tendu is when, here, I'll try to move the screen so you can see it better. So obviously we have parallel and then we go to our first position. A tendu is when you point your foot. Can everyone do that? Perfect. So you point your foot and you try to keep your heel forward. So instead of like turning your foot in, you want to try to keep your legs turned out. And you can do tendus to the front. You can do tendus to the side, and you can do tendus to the back. Although, doing tendus to the back is kind of hard, so we're going to keep it forward and side. Yeah, does anyone have any questions so far? No? You do? Okay, I will raise your hand if you have a question. Hi. I unmuted you. What's your question?
Is there an arrow in the sea?
Is there an arrow in the sea?
Yeah.
What do you mean by that?
The animal that swims and it has a tail on the back.
Are you talking about a dolphin?
Yeah.
What about a dolphin?
It can go up and go down.
Yes, it can. Okay. Does anyone have any questions about ballet and what we've learned so far? No? Okay. Then we're going to do a tendu combination. Going to put the computer back down. We're going to pick another Frozen song. And we are going to do a little tendu combination. Do you guys like, do you want to build a snowman? Yeah? Okay, so follow along.
Do you want to build a snowman? Come on, let's go and play. I never see you anymore. Come out the door. It's like you've gone away. We used to be best buddies. And now we're not. I wish you would tell me why. Do you want to build a snowman?
Let's go and walk the way of snowman.
Okay, bye. Do you want to build a snowman or ride our bike around the halls?
Good.
I think some company's overdue. I've started talking to the pictures on the walls. Hang in there, Joan. It gets a little lonely. All these empty rooms just watching the hours tick.
Now we're going to go to the side.
Now that you've learned what a tendu is, we're going to learn what a dégagé is. A dégagé is when you do a tendu, but if this was your foot and this is the floor, you do a tendu, your toes stay on the floor, but if you do a dégagé, your toes brush off the floor. So I'll show you what that looks like. So this was our tendu, when our toes stay on the ground, but a decochet is when you brush off. Good. You brush off. You point your toe off the floor. You're supposed to push into the ground and it forces your foot to come up. Like that. We can do it on the left. And just like tendus, you can do decochets to the front, to the side, and to the back, but we're only going to be doing to the front and to the side. Can you teach jumps, please? Yes, we're doing that next, actually. We're gonna do sautés. Okay, so we're gonna do decochets. Follow along. You learn a plié, a grand plié, a tendu, and a décoché. Now, we're going to learn how to do sautés, which are basic jumps you do in center. And then we're going to do a grand battement combination, which is, well, I'll show you what it is, but we're going to do sautés first. So, pull it down again. Sautés, or jumps, are when you're in first position so that your legs are turned out. Remember that plié that we learned? When you bend, this is the most important part of your jumps. This is what helps you get off the floor, and it's what helps you land safely without damaging your knee or any other parts you like. So, your arms are low fifth, and you're in first position, take a plié, while keeping your shoulders back and your tummy in, and then just push off. Everyone try that? Good. So once again, plié and jump. Good. Remember to point your toes out as you come off the ground. That's really important. So you can do jumps from first and then second. Your arms go side, even though they're plié, and you jump. Good. And then we're gonna do a fun little combination. So we're going to do four jumps in first. So one, two, three, four. Then we're gonna tendu to the side, push down, and go one, two, three, four. And then we're gonna go back to first, and we're gonna do it one more time. So, four jumps in first, tendu to second, four jumps in second, tendu back to first, and then repeat. So, pick another song. But first, does anyone have any questions about that? Dance-related questions? You do? Okay, I'll unmute you. Hi, Alan?
So when you go out on your, when you point your toe, mm-hmm. how much weight do you put on your toe versus on the ball of your front of your foot?
There's supposed to be no weight in your working leg. All the weight is in your standing leg.
And so you go, you're just touching the very front of the, your toes?
Yeah, I'll show you. So,
okay, watch
if I was putting weight on it, it would be incorrect. So this is what would be incorrect.
because then I'm rocking forward. Right?
Okay.
So a tendu or a degage, your toe is barely touching the ground, so I should be able to do this little bit.
So your foot's almost arched.
Your foot is pointed.
Okay.
So essentially, if this was the floor and this is your foot, you want to be pushing into the floor, but you're not putting weight on it.
Okay.
Your foot is just slightly pushing into it. And then you point, but you should still be able to lift it off.
Okay.
Yeah.
We got it. Yes, thank you.
Any other questions? No? Let's do our jump combination. Let's pick. Ooh, this one's fun. Okay, follow along.
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
Breathe.
I love crazy.
All my life has been a series of doors in my face. And then suddenly I bump into you.
I was thinking the same thing. Cause like, I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate fondue.
But with you, I see your face, and it's nothing like I've ever known before. Love is an open door. Love is an open door. Love is an open door. With you,
with you,
with you,
with you.
Good job. Okay. So now that we've learned that, we're gonna do a bot moth. Ma is so we do bot ma's from first position. So everyone at first. Very good. A bot ma is when you brush your leg up. So like that. Everyone try it. Just kick your leg up there. Perfect. Okay. So what you want to keep in mind is posture. So tummy in, shoulders back. But also, you don't want to go forward. So if I'm doing a bot ma, I don't want to go like this, right? Keep all your weight in your standing leg. Kick up and down. And keep your leg as straight as possible. Everyone just keep doing that a couple times. Good, Penny, keep your legs straight when it's coming down. Better, that's good. Good, Savannah. Relax your wrists a little bit. Perfect. That's so pretty. Everyone's doing really good. Okay, so you can do them to the front like this. Oh, hang on, someone. My computer died, so what are we doing? We are learning bot ma's, which are kicks. So just go over again. It's when you brush your leg up. Try to keep your legs as straight as possible and keep your posture, how we learned earlier. So you can do that on the right and you can do that on the left. You can also do it to the side. To the other side. You just want to make sure you're not lifting our toes pointed. Yes, your toes are always pointed in ballet. There's really no times your toes are never not pointed. If you're doing more of a modern ballet, maybe, but they're always pointed. So we have 4 minutes. We're gonna do a fun little follow along with bot ma's. So just follow. First position, arms. and 5, 6.
I mean, it's crazy. We finish each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say.
I've never met someone who thinks so much like me. Drinks, kids again. Elemental synchronization. Can't have the one explanation. You and I were just meant to be.
Four. Say
goodbye.
One. Okay, so that's Bot Ma. Does anyone have any questions about anything that you learned today? No? What has been your favorite thing that you learned today? Whose was plies? Whose was tendus? Dégagés. What about sautés? So your jumps. Yeah? And your bot mods, your kicks. Yeah? Cool, I'm glad you guys liked it. So we're gonna do a little follow along, like stretch, and then we're gonna say goodbye. And when you say goodbye in ballet, it's just a follow along in center. So I'm gonna put on another Frozen song and we're gonna stretch. Should our last song be in summer? No, some people are saying no. Oh, okay. What about for the first time in forever? No? Should we play Let It Go again? You guys like that one? Yeah? No? Okay, there's so many people wanting in summer. We're doing in summer. Or reindeer are better than people. Want that one? Okay. Follow along.
Reindeers are better than people. Sven, don't you think that's true?
Yeah, people will beat you and curse you and cheat you. Every one of them's bad, except you.
Oh, thanks, buddy. But people smell better than reindeers. Sven, don't you think I'm right?
That's once again true, for all except you.
You got me. Let's call it a night.
Good night.
Don't let the frost bite.
Okay. Those are the skills you learned today. Okay. I think the song's ended. So that song's over. Now we are going to do a little thank you. So just follow me. Put your leg behind your other one. And up here. Yay! I'm clapping the end of class. Okay. Thank you, guys. I'm really... Yes, I love that song, too. I'm really happy you decided to take my class. And I hope you learned something. Yeah? Who else loves ballet? I do. Yes. I'm so glad there's boys taking this class. Ballet needs more boys. Okay. Jessica, are you there?
I am. Good job.
Thank you. They did so good.
You guys, everybody wave goodbye to Coach Jordyn. She's going to be doing a couple other things this week. She's going to write a story. Coach Katie is going to do some cooking, so make sure you guys register for classes, okay? Bye, everyone. We're going to close the meeting up.
Bye. Thank you.